Hello everyone, I'm Bunjin, the creator of Deck.Toys. It's actually very easy to turn your existing worksheets into interactive slides with the use of the Deck.Toys Slide apps. In this video, I will show you how to upload your PDF worksheets and also using the screen snip tool to quickly create the slides. Then, we will use the powerful slide apps to make the slides interactive. So, let's start. First of all, I have prepared an example worksheet that consists of different question types, including student entering long answers, and student can draw and also fix specific answers. There is also several different other question types here. So let's move on to the deck editor, where we can add our slide activity into the deck. In the slide activity, you can upload an image or choose an existing image from your Google Drive or Google Image Search. For now, we're going to upload the PDF that we have created earlier. So now I'm uploading the PDF. It will be automatically converted into images. The images will be entered into slides, as you can see here. And now we are able to add the slide apps into the slide image that we have added. So here we are going to add, for this define parameter, we're going to add a text field. You just drag the text field into it and drag the position where the student is going to enter the text. So this area will be an interactive part of the slide. And then for the students to draw, you can use the draw app. Just drag the slide app into it. And here will be the draw area for the students. And on the question number 3, we are going to add the a popular app on Deck.Toys, which is a lock. As it's a specific answer, it works best for this scenario. The students will need to enter a specific answer before they are able to proceed. So for here, the answer should be 10. You can also have a text input, but for here, in this question, we're going to use the number lock. So the answer is 10. The students reaching to this slide activity will need to enter 10 before they move on, otherwise they'll get stuck. So on this next slide, we're going to use different apps. So for example here, which shape has a larger area? We can use place marker app. So the place marker app, you can drag and fit to the area where this place marker, the students where can place the place marker. Later on, I will show you how it will turn out in a classroom. And for the recently I've added the MCQ app. Here you have the you have any MCQ question, you can just add the MCQ app to it where the students can choose the answers. So you can have a question and also the answers. But for now, since the question is already on the slide, you can just put the options A, B, C, D there and the correct answer for the students to answer. So here the students will need to answer B before they are able to proceed. And then for showing the working, you have the photo app where you require the students to take a photo and put it into the slide. So this is an interesting app. And for this, we can also put the text app if you want the students to enter an answer. And finally, in this slide, we're going to add a quick poll to gauge the students' understanding. It can be different kind of types, and popular one will be the 1 to 5 stars. Next, I will show you how to use the screen snip tool. So first, you create a new empty slide, and you can go to your any existing material, whether it's a PDF or even a Google Doc. So here is an example from Google Drive. You can use you can use the screen snip tool by Windows Shift S key, which come out the screen snip tool, and then you will copy into the clipboard. Then in Deck.Toys, you can just Control V to paste it inside. So with this, you can quickly add new images into the slides. For this example, we're going to use the drag and drop tool. So the drag and drop tool will turn your existing slide into draggable areas where the students will need to return the position. So here, for example, we're going to add the drag target area. So this is one drag target area, and we can add multiple. So students will need to move the area to the correct position to be able to unlock this activity. So we will save it now. Our slide activity is actually ready for students now. And let's see the preview. If you click on the preview deck, you open the classroom in the test classroom. So here on the left is the teacher's view, and on the right is the student's view. And we will go through the slide apps that we added. So for example, this is the first slide. Students cannot move on until they've entered their answer. So here, the first one, the students have to define the parameter. So they can type any text long answer here. And for the teacher, the response can be seen in real time. So for example, I've the students that entered the answer, all the answers will be shown here. You can also view the students' answers in the classroom report, which is in a printable format. And for shade the area, so students can shade the area and press submit. Similarly, after submitting, the teacher can view the answers in real time. And the popular app, which I mentioned, the student can move on until they have completed this. So this is a number lock. If they entered a wrong answer, so let's enter the wrong answer, yeah, they cannot unlock it until they entered the correct answer, which is 10 in this case. And when they answer correctly, they can move to the next slide. So on this next slide, we have the place marker app. And here, the students can drag a place marker into the position they would like. So it can be anywhere in this region. And then for the MCQ question, like just now we added the ABCD, you could have also entered the whole question inside here with the question on top, and then all the four different answers or many multiple answers too. So here we have, if you entered wrongly, you will get wrong and get less points. The students will get less points. And the photo app will be useful for the students to show their working. In this case, I will use an iPad later for this example. And for the answer, the subjective answer means the students can enter any answer they want. So for example, if they enter a wrong answer, they can also go to continue. If you want them to answer, get specific answer correct, you use the log. And the students can rate the question. So I will show you the photo app with the iPad. And here we are going to see how the photo app looks like in the student's view. So allow the camera. So by default, it's the front face camera. You can switch to the rear camera. So we're gonna switch to the rear camera. And here the students can take a picture of their answers. You also can use it to take anything outside of in your classroom too, for depending on the assignment. You can submit the photo. The photo will be appearing into the teacher's view. So let's see how it turns out for the one I have just uploaded. So this the image I've taken from the iPad is shown here. So you can see now you're able to receive the photo responses. It can be the photo of themselves or even the photo of their answers. Finally, let's continue to the last slide with the drag and drop app. In this slide app, students will be required to rearrange the target areas to the correct position. If they have given a wrong answer, they will be unable to continue. But if they get it right, so let's put the correct answer, they will be able to continue with the slide activity. And if after completing, the answers will be revealed. So that's all for today's demo. I hope that you have managed to learn and also use the different ways to not only get your student responses, but also to engage your students with the use of the Deck.Toys Slide apps. Thanks.